Hey everybody, welcome back. We're doing another Marvel Future Revolution video. In this one, I'm gonna be talking about some things that I'd call immediate fixes, maybe immediate adjustments that I would personally make to the game. I've been talking to a lot of people, obviously doing some videos with Halfcent, talking to people in the Discord. I had a long good talk with Newfin today, member of X-Force, very good, strong player. He's been playing a lot of mobile games, or a lot of games in general. I'm pretty familiar with how a lot of these do well. So I want to give him a giant shout out, because some of these ideas are definitely sort of like motivated from our conversation. So I'm going to throw this out there. Let me know what you guys think of what I'm throwing out there. Let me know what you think other methods could be to make the game a little better, because I do believe at the foundation of this game is so much goodness. There can be a lot here that is really, really good. I think it's just, it needs to take a few more steps, and my hope is that they do that sooner rather than later, so that we can keep a lot of the people who are here already and bring in more players, because the more people that come in to play the game, I think the more fun it will be. So anyway, if you're new to the channel, check out the Discord link in the description below. Hammer down like buttons, click notification bells, and we're doing another gold giveaway, so stick to the end, check out what you got to say there, and comment below on that. All right, so check it out. Okay, so I'm gonna have Widow sort of doing my thing in the background here. One of the things that I want to mention first is replayability, and this is something Newfin and I talked about a ton today. You know, the game is pretty lacking in that regard. One aspect I actually do like about it is I don't have to feel like I'm on the game all day, but there should be some aspects about where when I do get time, I can do things. So right now I just come in, I do my blitz, I do my spec ops, raid, whatever. One of the ideas that Newfin threw out there, I actually think is a really good idea, is the ability to replay some of these blitzes. And maybe not, you won't get the squad rank, you won't get the gold, but you can still get these blitz badges. And this helps you because you run this five times a day and you never get what you want, right? So in a game like WoW, I would run a dungeon X number of times, right? And once I got my gear, I was like, oh great, I don't have to worry about running that, but I'll run it to help other people to get through it. Now, in a game like this, I'd still run the blitz mode, but I wouldn't necessarily be worried about the gear part of it. So I think they have any of the paying for blitz badges specifically, but I would love to do that for two reasons. One, min-max out my badges, get what I need to here, where it's kind of like, okay, so maybe, you know, I need a specific, you know, badge here and I just can't get it. Let me get, you know, that's actually a pretty decent one, but it's got two red cores. I'm like, well, I need a green core. So, and it's lower than 110. So it's a little bit less, you know, stats there. All right, well, I'm not gonna use it, but it's a good badge. You know, or say maybe this one, I want a little bit different stats here, or I want on this cooldown decrease and all, like this to me right now, this is like, I'm not touching this thing. This is a great badge for me in the 6 slot. 5 slot? Maybe it could be a little different, right? Maybe I drop that HP recovery and get something different, et cetera, et cetera. So, you know, but maybe you get stuck with this where it's like, ooh, you know, I wanted 2 cooldown decreases instead of HP recovery and a stam. Yeah, that is the answer that I'd like there, but I don't want a yellow core. So, you know, being able to rerun those a little bit would be worthwhile. And maybe it's something where you get a certain amount per week where you can rerun it, and it's a ticket situation. So that way, you know, there is some limitation there, because one of the things we also talked about is it seems like Netmarble wants to make sure we don't get too far ahead of ourselves, or really what I should say is too far ahead where we're right on their heels of needing more and more and more, which honestly I will say is smart, because gamers these days, especially in these type of games, will burn and burn and burn to get to the end game and then be like, well, where's my stuff? I got nothing to do. I got nothing to do. So I can appreciate their slowing us down a little bit, but at the same time I think there's a happy medium in between there. So replayability, the grind for blitzes, I think if you throw that in the game it might be decent. Another thing is using alts to potentially go do some quests or doing things, and I don't mean just like, easy auto stuff. I mean, semi-easy, but doing something. And it feels somewhat rewarding where I'm getting something in return to build that character up. Because, you know, right now there's no real reason to bring your characters up yet. But the way the game's laid out, it seems like that would make sense, right? So, you know, if you have the ability to take one of your, you know, alts out there and sort of like go, I want to go do this, I want to go do that. Okay, you know, maybe that's something you want to do. I would love to be able to do that to get something done and build that character up. Training grounds, it's close, but not quite there. You know, it's 3 hours per week. I don't know. I'm looking more for a way to, you know, send them out on some sort of mission type thing. And not, I mean, and there's Black Desert Mobile, another example where you'd have workers to do that, but that was more of a, it takes 2 minutes, send them out, they're done in 3 or 4 hours. Not necessarily looking for that. I like, one of the things I like about this game is not feeling like I need to get on every 3 or 4 hours or set timers outside of, you know, maybe Alliance War or something like that. So, or even like a Dark Zone situation. So I'm going to put that out there. Again, I'm not going to harp on the next point, but PvE modes. PvE modes, we need these, more of them. I think while I think PvP can drive a lot of income, I think PvE will drive a ton of income and also retain players for longer and keep them interested. You put that kind of stuff out there, you know, Hafs and I have done multiple videos on this, you know, dungeon crawls, different things where it's hard to get, you know, you have to act in a certain, you know, sequence to be able to get a, you know, a title or something along. Calista and I were talking about WoW today, and she was saying about like the Undying. For anybody who knew about that, it was this really complex title to get, and you had to have your entire guild or your raid squad in there all follow through the entire raid. And if somebody died once the entire week, the week was thrown away for that run, so you have to wait till next week. Stuff like that is fun. It is challenging. It is, while it can get frustrating, it gives you some nice end game challenge there. And people love titles. They love titles to put out there, you know, and it doesn't take much. It's a little name thing, right? So you will see people grind for things like that. So let's get some PvE modes in the game, end game PvE modes that feel really good. A lot of the other stuff we talked about is in the other videos, so I'm not gonna harp on that much longer. Or at all. Next, Dark Zone. So there is so much debate on Dark Zone. I typically try to stay away from the real drama behind it. I like going in and fighting it because I feel like it's a PvP zone, so I don't view that as drama. I look at it as, if you're gonna walk into a gym or a boxing ring, you expect punches thrown back at you, regardless of what it is. Now, we have rules in our alliance that is like, just don't be a A-hat, basically. You know, don't spawn camp, stuff like that. But, you know, there's plenty of people out there do it, and okay. You know, but we just like to fight, right? We want to fight, we want to get our points, we want to try to get high rankings, even though the rewards are terrible. And we'll get to some of that stuff later. But in the end, this game mode is kind of a PvE, PvP, but it's really more of a PvP zone. So, I want to talk about a good example of an endgame PvP, maybe a little different than this one, because this one, I think, is... The game mode is a mixture and it's okay, but I think there would be a nice way to put some pure PvP endgame in this, where it would be, again, shout out to Newfin and Black Desert Mobile, Castle Sieges. So the way that game works, or that mode works a little bit in there, is where you're fighting other alliances on this Castle Siege, you're defending it, and depending who wins, they get to be able to get to certain mats for that week. So for instance, let's say in this game, maybe there's challenges within Dark Zone and certain alliances are in there and we're fighting each other and it's pure PvP. We're also fighting some bosses that we've got to take down maybe within a certain time or something, or maybe we all converge on one boss and whatever alliance does the most damage to that boss. So yeah, you want to kill each other, but also kill the boss. So it's just like this crazy, like, all right, well, Alliance A did the most damage. So they've get, you know, there's certain stages in here, they get the top points in that stage, and then there's a final stage, and depending on speed and sequence, you get the points there, and it's a 10 to 15 or 30 minute thing, and by the end of it, it ranks all these different things and goes, Alliance C, you're the one who had the highest score here, you get full access to this other zone that you can farm, you know, end game materials in for this week, and you know, it's not endless, but it's some reasonable thing, and then the next week it's on to it again. You know, but it is truly a situation where there's multiple alliances in there. And it's something where different people can sort of fight each other. And it wouldn't necessarily just go to strongest because, you know, maybe the people who won the week before, they have to be defending it like Castle Siege. And maybe it's harder to defend it because you've got multiple alliances coming at you and it is so hard. And then so all those alliances come and it's likely that one of those alliances is going to beat you. Something like that would be super cool. So I would love for them to sort of maybe evolve Dark Zone into something along those lines. I think it would be great, and you would treat all alliances semi-equally, you know, at least if it's somebody like X-Force who's super strong, or Penthouses, or Endgame, or Chaos Theory, or all these other alliances, they couldn't just hold on to that because they'd have to take the winner's role, and people would come at them, and it would be super hard to hold that ground. So anyway, the next thing, world bosses. Half-Cent talked about this. Check out his video. My opinion, it'd be cool. You know, make these things 3 to 5 times harder than the primes in Dark Zone at the moment. You want the entire server or a lot of the server to be able to come and do this. These things will despawn after 10 to 15 minutes. And there's some sort of announcement in world that says, you know, so-and-so's coming. You know, Hela's coming to the game. She's going to, you know, wreak havoc all over the place unless you defeat her, blah, blah, blah. And if you don't defeat her, you know, maybe, you know, that means you can't farm Convergium or you can't do something else. Or if you do beat her, it means there's more Convergium everywhere. I don't know. I'm just making stuff up. But that would be really cool. And maybe, you know, depending on how much damage you would do to her or something along those lines. I hate that this game leans so much into damage, but I just don't know what to think of besides that at the moment. You know, that person gets a little treasure chest with a, you know, guaranteed 4-star, 5-star piece of fodder because we need more of that. So next thing, rewards. They need to be improved badly. Dark Zone, for all the drama that's caused behind it, the only thing that's really all that exciting for it is the title. And that's still like a, you know, e-widget type thing that's just a title. You know what I mean? It does nothing, right? So the rewards, the badges in there are pretty lackluster. So otherwise, it's just some cards that you have to sometimes fight for. Okay. You know what I mean? So now you do get the gold now. I will give them that. So you get the gold now. But I do think there's something there that needs to be increased, you know, with this. You know, I spend all week to get this situation and I don't get something great. Now, my hope is at some point they evolve that. They get so far ahead of their content that they don't need to gate us and slow us down too much. But anyway, I'll throw that out there. Fodder. That ties into the rewards. I've mentioned this a couple times. We need more. Especially if they want us to build multiple tunes, which, as I mentioned, they haven't done yet, right? But I expect that at some point they're probably going to do something, right? Maybe, maybe not. But if they do, we need to have more fodder. There's just not there. And this kind of dives into my last point is if they're going to continue to balance the way they did, they got to give us a way to easily flow either from character to character or gear set to gear set. Now, you might want to say, well, transmuting. No, because if I've got Xandarth on a character or some gear set that only is good for that character and I can't easily transfer it to another one, or if I can't easily transfer or say, Mike, I'm a Spider-Man. And I don't want to play another character and I'm stuck with Xandarth. Now what? Am I just going to quit the game? I just spent 6 months, you know, building this setup because it was, you know, a good set in game, and now it's not. So they need to give us a way to like try to transverse that a little easier so that we can actually, you know, be more flexible with what our things are. I get there's got to be a pay model here, but I think that if you give us some of these replayabilities, these different modes, these ways that we want to actually spend to, you know, grind some of this stuff, it's going to be there. Those $8, those $10, those $25 offers. People who are in the game a lot, playing a lot, they're going to say, you know what? I haven't spent in 2 months. I'm going to drop $50 this month. Okay. You know, like that's a hobby. That's what people will do. I'll spend $50 because this is my hobby. I enjoy it. And this, what I'm paying for is actually going to give me something, right? So that's what I just wanted to say, some of these things, real quick hit. Let me know what your thoughts are. I really do think that the foundation of this game, it is super cool. There's so many different skills that you can go down, so many different trees you can go down, so many different characters. Marvel's cool. The gameplay is super smooth. It's really nice. There's stuff here. There is stuff here. So I hope the player base can grow, not shrink. I hope that we keep getting people to stay, not leave. I want to see this game continue to go. I want to see people continue to play it. I personally like it a lot. So that's what I got to say about that. Gold giveaway. 3 players. What I want to hear below is bring me PvE. That's it. Bring me PvE. Obviously a playoff to bring me Wolverthor. I probably didn't do as well. Sorry. apologies. No, no apologies. Not apologetic on that. Because we want some PvE. So we're going to say that. So say, bring me PvE. Comments below. You'll be enrolled in the drawing sometime later this week. We'll pick three winners. Random from those comments. If you didn't see, I did the gold giveaway winners on my last video. So if you were one of the people who said Spidey can't dodge this, go check out that video to see if you were one of the winners. All right, that's all I got. Discord link in the description below. Hammer down like button, click notification bell, subscribe. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day.